Good morning.
Dr. Xiangguo Qiu has been recognized by the Governor General's Innovation Awards.
This work can't be done without teamwork.
She and the team at the National Microbiology Lab have been praised for developing an Ebola vaccine. But just over a week ago, Qiu, her husband, and her students from China were evicted from Canada's only level 4 lab, their security access revoked. Staff at the lab was told last Monday the couple is on leave and not to communicate with them.
We're getting this from sources who work at the lab, but who don't want to be identified for fears they'll be punished. They say this is coming just months after IT specialists entered Qiu's office after hours and replaced her computer, and her superiors stopped authorizing work trips to China.
Manitoba RCMP confirmed it was called in by the Public Health Agency of Canada on May 24th. A spokesperson says the agency is investigating a policy breach, calling it an administrative matter, and it's taking steps to resolve it expeditiously. We can assure Canadians that there is no risk to the public and that the work of the NML continues in support of the health and safety of all Canadians.
All this, of course, is unproven, but even microbiology, sometimes especially microbiology, can have issues that involve national security.
It's something CSIS has already warned about.
Canada is facing threats from foreign espionage, and not just in the traditional sense of trying to understand what our national security interests are and agencies are involved with, but threats to our economic security.
Canada's relationship with China has been strained ever since the detention of a Huawei executive on a U.S. arrest warrant. Shortly after, China detained two Canadians, accusing them of stealing state secrets. This likely won't go over well and could even deepen the diplomatic divide. Karen Pauls, CBC News, Winnipeg.